The book of Genesis, Genesis chapter 27, and I want to read verse 40. Genesis 27, verse 40. And by thy sword shalt thou live, and shalt serve thy brother. And it shall come to pass, when thou shalt have dominion, that thou shalt break his yoke off thy neck. I want you to mark this in your Bible, that thou shalt break his yoke off thy neck. There is one thing that is common with Adonai. Whenever man put himself in trouble, God always comes to our rescue. And I love the book of Genesis chapter 27, the story of how Jacob, you know, received the blessing by serving the food and, you know, the cunningness and the rest. But that's not the point, and that's not where we are going. When Esau returned with the venison to the father after the preparation and, you know, said, my father, it's time to eat the way you always love your venison. I have done it the way you always want it to be done. And the father seems to be confused, saying, is that Esau, my son? No, it can't be. Well, your brother was here, and I've given him all the blessing. And the man strive and cry at the same time. He was striving himself. He was fighting himself and at the same time crying that this is the same way this young man tricked me to have my birthright with a porridge. And that's not where we are going to. But the man also said to the father, are there no blessing I can have from you as a father? The father now pronounced, okay, since I have given everything to him, I've also mentioned that you, the brother, will also serve the junior one. I've mentioned that to him. But there is always a way out. The same way God has given man a way out. In every predicament that man has put himself, God gave us a way out. The same way when Moses was leading the people of Israel and they began to murmur and the snake began to bite, God gave them a way out. So I'm talking to you today about God's way out. What did I say? God's way out. Out of what? See, one of the things God didn't want us to do is just to get out of every situation. God wants us to be out and then wants us to go up. God wants us out and he wants us to go up. And that's why I love what the father pronounced upon Esau. Let me read that scripture again. And by thy sword shalt thou live. You can see the word that is used in this scripture, shall. This is like there is no alternative to it. There is no way to it. The only way is this. That's the only way. It says, and by thy sword shalt thou live, and shall serve thy brother. And it shall come to pass, when thou shalt have dominion. So when thou shalt have dominion, this is the life that God wants man to have from the beginning. This is the life God handed over to man from the beginning. The Bible says God created man in his own image and in his likeness, and he gave dominion so that we have a domain. We can rule in wherever we are as a man. But we know that man fell, man sinned, man left God's presence, man left God's authority. But that's not the point I'm trying to make. But look at the language of the father. Look at the language of Isaac. He recognized the plan and the purpose of God, and he pronounced it upon the son that unless you have dominion. I love the scripture. The Bible says, to them that believe him, he gave them the power to become the sons of God. That shows whenever we believe, we have power to become. We are not just becoming, but something spectacular comes with it. In the next 10 seconds, I just beg of you to pray. But what is the prayer you're going to be praying? Yes, you want God's way out. Many times the Bible says we pray amiss, and that's why we don't get the answer. Many times, and I say many times, the Bible made it known to us that we always pray amiss, and that's why we don't get the answer. Because even at times when we pray rightly, the next thing that comes into our head, into our mind, is doubt. And at the same time, we're going to lose that which we have already secured. So what am I trying to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, is that God wants you to pursue power. God wants you to pursue dominion. The same way Adam lost it in the beginning, and it was given back to man in Christ Jesus. Look at the life of the apostles. They came to Jesus when Jesus was about to leave. They said, "Master, will you then restore the kingdom back to Israel?" And Jesus looked at them, said, "It is not for you to know the time or the season, but you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you." You see, God is interested in you as a child of God to have power. God is interested in you to operate in dominion. God wants you to walk in dominion. God wants you to sleep and wake up in dominion. God wants every day of your life to be in dominion. That's why the Bible says, "In him we move, in him we live, in him we have our being." When you understand that scripture that says in him, in him, in him, in him, in him, then you understand that you need to walk in dominion. Walk in God's authority that has been handed over to you. People of God, look at the scripture. It says, "When you shall have dominion, then you will break the yoke of thy neck. Thou shalt break the yoke." So the only way for yoke to be broken is to operate in dominion. The only way for yoke to be destroyed is to walk in dominion. But today, we human will left the presence of the Most High. We rebel against God. We don't even want to hear the name that is above every other name anymore. Even in the so-called Church of God today, we have many pastors that has left the presence of the Most High. They have adjusted their calling with one thing or the other because of crowd. And at the end of the day, if you as a pastor, you have adjusted your calling so that crowd can come, you are no longer walking in dominion. So then there is a yoke on your neck. Except you break the yoke. How? Walk in dominion. Have dominion. Have power. To them that received him, he gave them the power to become the sons of God. I love the young man called Solomon. When the man mounted the throne of his father David, God came after the man has offered sacrifice unto the Lord for thanksgiving. God came. He said, "You young man, ask me anything, and I'm ready to hand it over to you." The man Solomon did not go for money. The man Solomon did not go for wealth. The man Solomon seek for wisdom. The Bible says wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, get understanding. So he sought for wisdom, because the man wants to walk in dominion. Dominion. Anybody that walks in dominion is a man that knows that he's got a domain. And when God created man in the book of Genesis, even before the creation, God said, "Let us create man in our own image, in our likeness, and let them have dominion over all that we have." What are the all? You see, God began to list it. So God said, "I'm putting man in charge to have have dominion, to dominate over everything." Are you a child of God? Are you a child of God? Are you a child of God? Then, if you are, you have no doubt in your heart, you are a child of the Most High. Dominion automatically comes with it. That's the truth. The same way God created Adam and dominion. Adam did not go begging for dominion. Adam did not go saying to the lions and everything that you need to submit to me. You need to bow to me. It came naturally, because when God was creating the man, he embedded dominion into the man, naturally speaking. Can you see what I'm saying? So we are meant to walk in dominion. And that's why when Jesus, the lion of the tribe of Judah, came on the face of the earth, walking in dominion is easy. You will see that there is one thing that is spectacular about Jesus. The Bible says he will pray all night. He allowed the Holy Spirit to lead. When he finished baptism, the Bible says he was led by the Holy Ghost into the wilderness, you see, submitting himself to the Spirit of the Most High so as to walk in dominion. So that's what the father of Esau was telling, that you need to go and pursue one thing. If there is anything you're going to pursue, let it be dominion. Because the moment you have dominion, you will then break the yoke of serving your brother. You will then break the yoke of your birthright that has been taken. So whatever the yoke may be, it is about you having dominion. So to be able to break the yoke, the same thing God did for the children of Israel, the yoke of slavery was broken because God gave them dominion. God gave them dominion that, listen, I have a land for you that you need to go to. You will occupy the land. You will increase in the land. The land is full of milk and honey. That's your domain. Where you are right now is not your domain. And that's what I'm about to do for you. So I want you to pray in the next 10 seconds, people of God, that Father, empowerment, Lord. See, many times we don't know that we, as children of God, we need to seek the face of God like the apostles did in the upper room. They sought the face of God and power came. The Bible says power came, and the power divided himself upon each and every one of them like a cloven tongue of fire. The moment they received that power, they began to walk in dominion. That's why it was easy when Peter and John was walking into the temple and there was a man lame at the beautiful gate. They were able to hold the man's hand and pull him up. Said, silver and gold we have none, but such as we have. So to break every yoke, I don't know the yoke that has been upon you for this long, but there is a way out. Seek for dominion. No wonder the scripture says, when Jesus was asked, says, Master, teach us how to pray. When Jesus started, he said, okay, when you need to pray in the book of Luke, when you want to pray, start acknowledging the presence of your father. When you acknowledge the presence of your father, then reference your father. After that, seek that his kingdom, because you are right here on the face of the earth, you represent a kingdom. You are from a domain that is not here. You will go back to that domain. So let that which is happening in the domain that you came from be established here because you are here. I want to pause here. I just want us to pray for about 10 seconds. That Father, I want to walk in dominion. Why did you think Jesus was able to defeat death and grave? Because he walks in dominion. Before death and grave, look at how Jesus was walking upon the face of the earth. Did you not remember that the disciple could not cast out a demon? Jesus, they said to Jesus, okay, how come we cannot do this? Jesus says, this does not happen except by fasting and prayer. Look at us today as a church. How much time do we give to fasting and prayer? But most times when we fast and pray is what? Lord, bless me, bless me, bless me. That will not cause us to walk in dominion. Esau was not asked to go and be asking God for the blessings. Says, you seek dominion. Pursue dominion. If there is one thing you will pursue, pursue dominion. And once you have dominion, you will break the yoke off your neck. I pray that every yoke be broken as you pursue that dominion right now in the name of Jesus. By the power that is in resurrection, every yoke be broken. Every yoke. I don't know what the yoke is, but when you look at the life of Esau, there was an exchange. Yes, there was an exchange. See, a lot of people preach about the man called Jacob. But look at the life of that brother too. When the brother Esau finally met with the junior brother Jacob, when that one was offering all the goody goodies, all the wealth, the man Esau said, you don't need to offer me all of this. I've got more than enough. That shows he was able to pursue dominion. He was able to have dominion, and the yoke was broken off his neck. May every yoke that has not glorified God be broken off your neck in the name of Jesus. I stand upon the word of God right now in agreement with you that every yoke that is not of God, be destroyed completely by the power that is in the blood of Jesus, by the power of resurrection. In the name of Jesus, that yoke of miscarriage be destroyed in the name of Jesus. That yoke of not advancing be destroyed in the name of Jesus. That yoke of setback be destroyed in the name of Jesus. That yoke of lateness be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Look at what the Bible says. It says, seek ye first the kingdom and his righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto it. That's what Isaac motivate his son to go and seek for it. There he said, yeah, truly, you're going to have the sword in your hand. You're going to live by the sword. You will not be conquered. But to break this yoke of limitation, you need to seek for dominion. Every yoke of limitation, every yoke that has not caused you to advance, I declare that the power that is in the resurrection destroy. So be it unto you according to the word of God. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. The bottom line is, seek for dominion. Go after dominion. Pursue power from the Most High. Not any legitimate power. That will not do the job. But the Bible says, Jesus said, all power in heaven and on earth has been given unto me. So pursue the one with the power. Who am I talking about? The Lion of the tribe of Judah, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, Ancient of Days, Mighty One of Israel, the one that defeated the grave and the death. And the Bible says he ascended up high and he gave gift unto men. And as you do so, the reward is going to be something that will blow your mind. It will be something that your human nature cannot comprehend. So be it unto you according to the word of God. Pursue dominion. Seek dominion. Pursue power.